Here are the four YouTube analytics to watch, the ones that are really going to help you see what's working with your YouTube videos and where you can improve. I'm going to break it down really simply for you right now. So first up, real-time views. So this is how many views you've had on your videos in the last 48 hours. Now this gives you an early insight into the performance of your videos, into what time you should be uploading your videos as well. Now you can either view performance by the last 48 hours or 60 minutes. I tend to focus on the last 48 hours and each bar represents 1 hour of time. In the 60 minutes one, one bar is 1 minute. Now this data is refreshed every 60 seconds. So in a 48 hour period, you can see exactly when your audience is choosing to watch your videos the most, which helps you then adjust when you upload content. You also know when you should go in and reply to your comments and try and keep the conversation going, because you know when your audience is most likely to be on YouTube. Now, if you see a spike, it might be because you've emailed out to your list that your new video is live and it was your subscribers watching as soon as you released the video. But you can also see what topics are resonating with people who are already subscribed to your channel, are getting notified. You can view this data for individual videos and for your overall channel, and it's just here on the right. Now let's look at audience retention. Now audience retention is a measurement of how much of your video people watch. So head to the engagement tab of the YouTube analytics and it shows you how much of your videos your viewers are actually watching. And it shows you when viewers stop watching too. So let's have a look at retention for an individual video. So we can see that there's a drop off at the beginning. Now this can often mean that people have clicked on it by mistake, or it started playing but they've changed their mind. Something else has happened. Or it might be that your intro is too long, you're losing people's attention. So it might be a sign that you need to change something up, maybe shorten your intro. You might see a big drop off at the end of the video. That might be because that's where your end screen appears. But throughout the video, look for obvious points of people leaving. Now you can actually click on those points on the graph and it'll take you straight to that part of the video so you can see what was happening there. Ideally, you want a nice steady slope. It means that you're keeping your audience engaged. These big valleys mean that you need to see what's going wrong and make sure you keep your calls to action at the points of the video where most people are watching. So see what your average view duration is. If it's roughly halfway through that people are dropping off, make sure you put your calls to action in the first half of the video. Sometimes if you see an uptake, it's because people are re-watching parts of your video or being directed to that point in the video. Or it might be for another reason. So for example, I often see spikes at a point in my video where text graphics appear on the screen, maybe with a list or a diagram. And it's perhaps because people are skipping back to that point because they want to see that screen again to take the information in. Now, if you find this for your own videos, you might want to think about adding more of those graphics into your videos, because that's obviously a good thing that your audience likes. Now, traffic sources, this is literally where your viewers are coming from. So how people have actually ended up on your video. So stay in analytics and head to reach on the top tab. Now, external traffic, this is when you promote your videos by email, on your social media, in guest posts, for example, suggested videos, this is where YouTube has actually suggested your video to people, either when they've watched another video because they think the viewer might also enjoy this one, or they've seen it in the browse areas of YouTube. Search is when people have arrived at your video because your video showed up when they searched for a particular keyword or phrase. And it's great to get traffic this way because it's a predictable source of views and it means your videos will keep showing up while ever people are searching for a particular keyword or phrase. If you want to know more about optimizing your videos for search to take advantage of this, check out this playlist. Browse features. This is traffic from within YouTube. So traffic from the home screen, the subscription feed, watch later, and other browsing features. Keeping an eye on this part of your analytics means you can see where your traffic is coming from and what you can optimize further. If you're not getting a lot in the way of search, you might want to look at optimizing your videos for search a bit more. If you've not got much coming from external sources, it might mean that you could focus more on promoting your videos off YouTube. Now, your click-through rate, this measures how often viewers watched one of your videos after seeing a registered impression on YouTube. So if someone saw my title and thumbnail, it's how many people actually clicked through to watch the video. Now, the graph you'll see here in your analytics will look something like this. And according to Google, half of all channels and videos on YouTube have an impressions click-through rate that can be anywhere between 2 and 10%. So keep an eye on your click-through rate. But don't forget that if the pool of people YouTube is showing your video to jumps up, you may then get a lower percentage click-through rate, and that's okay. But in general, you want this click-through rate to be going, well, level or going up. Focus on your titles and thumbnails and think about how you could make them more engaging and enticing. Now ask yourself as well, is the text on your thumbnails bold enough? Is it legible? Is the thumbnail as a whole eye-catching and does it stand out? This is so important. I have a whole video on how to create standout thumbnails. So there we have it, a brief overview of your analytics, the main metrics that it's really important for you to track if you want to grow your channel. I hope that's shown you that analytics don't have to be scary or confusing. Let me know in the comments if you'd like to see more on the analytics side of things and how you can use them to improve your channel. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you next time.